Yep. Sonic 2, because why not? I love this game. It's my favorite one of the 2D ones, specifically on the Genesis Mega Drive. Yeah. With Tails. Now, usually I just play as Sonic or have AI Tails tag along. This time I'm just gonna play as Tails just to do something different, because every other damn video pretty much is always someone playing as Sonic. Although I'm pretty sure there's gotta be one out there or someone decided to do the same thing I just did, but whatever. So yeah, Sonic 2 is my favorite one. I know that's something you've most likely, even if you don't like Sonic or play it, you've heard so many times, like, Sonic 2 is my favorite Sonic game, and Streets of Rage 2 is my favorite Streets of Rage game, and, you know, Assassin's Creed 2 is my favorite Assassin's Creed, you know, stuff like that. It's the most common thing you've ever heard, but the truth is I really do like this one the most. But I'm gonna tell you why. This mainly comes down to a few things. One is the music, two is the levels themselves, like what they look like and their setup and all that. But mainly it's the level design and all the secrets. That is the reason I like this one. And it's got Tails. I also spent more time playing this and more time with it, and I still do, so there's a reason there too. I'm more, you know, used to it. It is the one I'm better at too, that and the first one. Now it doesn't mean I don't like the other ones, because I do. In fact, if I had to put them in order, what order I like them in, would go 2, 1, and then 3 for the Genesis Mega Drive. But that doesn't mean like I don't like any others, because I do, like I said. This is like, technically, the first Sonic game is actually better on the Master System than it is on the Genesis, because of due to the programming problems and coding and all that, but it doesn't mean it's a bad game, even on that. It's still good, yeah. It's just like the Castle of Illusion thing. Technically, it's better on the Master System, but whatever. Things like that happen. Yeah, but the main reason I like Casino Night Zone other than the music is because it's basically a giant... Thanks for that, you dick. It's a giant pinball machine. I actually don't like using the fast shoes for reasons you just saw. It's kind of hard to control. Hey, hey, hey. Usually I just spin dash by that. Damn, I'm not doing good with that. I'm getting up there now. This game is super fast. Get the checkpoint, why not? I don't really need it. This boss fight's easy, but I still think that the one in Chemical Plant Zone is the easiest. I've said that for a long time. I don't understand how he sucks up the purple acid stuff and it comes out blue. I don't get that. He turns it into blue ink, basically. My favorite boss fight has got to be the one in Aquatic Zone, even though I can't stand that place. The water level. Now, I'm not the same way as like other people with water levels. The reason I don't like water levels is because I find them boring, although I know a lot of people say that too. But specifically in Sonic games, which I'm pretty sure any of you who've played any know what I mean, is that sound that happens when you're about to drown. It's really, makes you kind of nervous. They did a good job with that. In fact, sometimes when that happens, Sonic games feel more like a survival horror game than actual survival horror games do. It's weird, but it's the truth. So, this egg is full of little birds and squirrels. No continue for me. If I didn't get hit those times, I could have probably had 100 rings and get a life. I always thought instead of like Mario, I came up with a way like they could store all these rings on them, other than they just, you know, you collect them and they're like magic, they just stay on you, is that they wore them like bracelets around their arms. Like, well, if you got like 100 of these ring things, it's gotta be a lot of friggin' weight, not to mention your arms can't be that big to hold them all. Oh shit. Well, looks like I'm not going there. Nah, take it back. Another thing I love about this game is all the alternate paths you can take. There's so many. They're not all good. Some are better than others. Some will lead you basically into a death trap of spikes, but you know, whatever. That's what happens. Robotnik is kind of a dick. Man, if only Bowser had the brains that Robotnik did for his level design. Mario might actually have never have won, ever. I hate those things. Those bees ain't that bad, except for when they grab you, obviously. But these blue fuckers, you can't kill them. I don't even know what to call them. Blue fuckers, that's what I always call them. Pricks. Ha, I made it. The hell just happened there? Yung. Nice. Aw, come on, you couldn't just make me land on that? You gotta make me do it the hard way. There's more of those blue bastards. I don't want nothing to do with you. Stay away. You're evil. Down, down. I like how when you look up as Tails, it glitches out the tail. But when you look down, it doesn't. It's one of those things. It's one of those weird things. Little eccentricities. Blah. And got it. And can I get bounced back? Yeah. Got it all without stopping. That's what we call Sonic class. You're not an uber Sonic player unless you can do that. Of course, that's pure bullshit, but whatever. And as I slowly coast to the finish line, with 69 rings, because, you know, that's just how it happens. It would do that. Funny story though, that actually happens a lot. I get 69 rings. I don't know why, but whatever. It's just a number. Oh god, I got up there. I didn't think I was gonna make it. And I end up going the same way I usually always do. I wanted to go the alternate path, but it didn't knock me into that way. Actually, you know what? Yeah, before I forget, I want my free bonuses. It's like Vector Man, you destroy TVs and get shit. That is weird, those two have that in common. Huh. Whatever. Time to beat Robotnik's ass again. There's only two parts in this level that can cause a problem. With the purple acids raising up and those platforms are moving around. Although a lot of times I try to get it before they start, the acid starts raising, which sometimes I can do it, sometimes I mess up. And when that thing can potentially catapult you into the acid, in which case you're basically dead, so you might as well just kill yourself anyway and restart. But yeah, basically. Reminds me of a giant Hot Wheels track, which I never had. Had a lot of cars, but I never had a track. Ooh, don't want to get squeezed. Well, Sonic's the fastest thing alive, he shouldn't need no little booster thing right there to help him get up to speed. I'm just saying. Although, if you're to believe things that you can find, supposedly shadows faster, but whatever. I still don't know what to think about that one. Yes, I made it before it even touches me. Yeah. Skillage. And I got 109 rings, I just realized. Apparently I've been doing really good and I haven't gotten hit. Robotnik's checking it, making it his list, and he's checking it twice. And apparently Tails has been good. That's what I was talking about right there, where it catapults you into the frickin' acid. That fucking red plunger bumper thing. You piece of shit, you got me again. You dick. One of these days, I'm gonna beat you. I'll yank your spring off. That didn't sound right. That red prick right there. Alright, shit, man. I could have had 1,000 rings by now, but nope. Alright, it's time to beat Robotnik's ass and hope I don't land in the... Ooh. I used to have problems with that the first time I ever played this, but not anymore. I really think this is the easiest boss fight. If you're in sync enough, like it usually happens like I am right now, you're not gonna get hit by his shit, and look how easy it is to just hit him constantly, because he's really close to where you are. It's not like you have to jump up high to get him or anything. And this one's full of young Bugs Bunnies and hawks. Looks like Apollo from my town in Animal Crossing. I don't know. Oh, 1 second off from 3 minutes. Damn. Disappointed. Oh god, this place. I don't want to go in the water. I hate the water. It's scary in Sonic games. That, and it's slow, and I don't like it. And it's wet. Get that. There you go. Yeah, I don't feel like bothering with the Chaos Emeralds. I never like getting them. I've done it. I've gotten them all at least a couple times. I just don't feel like doing it anymore. Yes! Oh, no. Usually, both of them get me, or at least one of them. No, 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 no. I don't want to go in the water. I don't want to go in the pool. I'm an age victim. How did I not get hurt by him? Tell me I wasn't the only one that just saw that. The game's throwing me a bone. I'm gonna take it with glee. Ah, yeah. Saved myself from going in the water. But that's not the hard one. The second act is the one where the problem with the water comes in. Especially if I miss those two platform things that swing right at the bat here. That doesn't help me. Asshole arrows. I hate these things. You can't kill them. Alright, this is what I was talking about. If I miss these things, I'm really screwed. Then I gotta have fun with the water. Which I don't want to do. Or if I fell down there. There's still plenty of chances I can end up in there. Which usually does happen to me. Because I'm not paying attention, and I go too fast, and then something horrible bites me in the ass. Like that. Nope, nope. Don't do it, don't do it. Oh man, oof. God. Sometimes you just go too fast in this. Alright, see, this water I don't mind. I can actually get out of it. Oh god, no, I'm in the water. Ooh, that was a triple kill. Yeah, get out of the way. Yeah, I think I'm safe. And yep, I'm safe. And get up on here, so no. Damn it. Could've got a free hit. I hate when it does the top arrow. You can't even jump on it to hit him. I didn't even think I was gonna make that one. Yeah, that one. I can't get there. And then there's the same one, the same height on the opposite side. I like when it shoots the same arrow at the same place and it knocks the other one out. That really helps. You figure you use a giant hammer to try and kill Tails and Sonic, but no. Robotnik's too lazy that way. He's not a hands-on evil genius. In fact, this is one of the few boss fights where he doesn't directly attack you. He's using indigenous structures to attack you. Arrow to the mouth. Sometimes I jump too soon and I get hit by the arrow. That's a bad habit I have on this boss fight. Thinking I can jump and just as soon as it hits, it lands and sticks itself, I can jump on it. But no. Again, how's he alive from that explosion? Shouldn't his hair been burnt off and his skin melting? So this one's full of penguins and flickies? They look like flickies. That's what this is. It's Flicky Island. I don't like your island. I can drown in it. Yay, Casino Night Zone. Now we're talking. Finally. I suffer through that crappy level to get to the one I love the most. Yeah, like I said, I like this because it's a giant pinball machine, basically. That and there's pretty much no enemies. The boss fight in this is a pain in the ass because it's very hard to directly land where you want to hit Robotnik, but, you know, I deal with it. I've never really found a good, accurate way to hit him directly. It's just one of the things that happens. But I still love it. I used to know the memorize the level skip code, and I used to just come here to play this. Because yes, I know about Sonic Spinball, I like it a lot, and I had it. But, sometimes the physics in that are a little weird, it's kind of floaty. And some days I just didn't feel like dealing with that, so I figured, you know what, I might as well just play Casino Night Zone. I've seen Casino Night Zone in a video for generations, and I went down. It looks really good. I still like this one the most, most likely, without a doubt, if I played that one, but, you know. It does look a lot like this, the music, too. It's a lot like this. Slightly updated. And launch. And I went over the bumpers. Oh, no, no, no. Aw. About to say, give me my free rings. Although sometimes you can get bounced around here for a very long time. Most people don't know or forget this. There you actually have a hidden like 10-minute time limit. So you actually have 10 minutes to do every course. And there you go. I think that's enough. So thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you next time. Adios.